didn't take long for me to go back to blue. What can I say? If anything, I'm consistent. Sure, we're a little late to the party on this particular pen, but this 2018 offering from Pelikan is one that was worth looking at. Now, sure, it doesn't have a fancy colorway, and it's only sporting a steel nib. And it didn't come with one of those fancy bottles of Königsblau. But this pen does something better. It comes in a classic style with a very well done blue and gold trim. So before we tackle the unboxing, let's take a look at the TLDW. Obviously, I like the color. The shade of blue for the resin is a nice complement to the blue ink window on this pen. The broad nib was smooth out of the box, flow is extremely on point, and it holds a fairly good amount of ink. So what would I have liked to see done better? I honestly would like to see Pelikan price their pens normally where I don't have to find them on sale to match European pricing. I mean, seriously, Pelikan, you make good pens. Quit milking the price. That aside, let's take a look at the pen itself. The M120 comes in a slimline box that's in line with the boxes used for the M600s. On the upper right, we have the Pelikan with a single chick, the Pelikan location and website, and on the end, a sticker indicating what's inside. Opening the box, the inner box is a little bit of a tease with a gray outer sleeve, and the inner sleeve is sporting some kind of faux cardboard. I'm okay with cardboard, I mean, you really didn't have to spruce it up. Anyways, inside is what we really care about. We've got the leatherette pouch containing the M120, and underneath that, we have the 3-point Pelikan warranty, Karen use guide, and regional distributor guide. Anyways, we're here for the pen, so let's get that out of the pouch and take a look. For today's comparison, we're going to put the M120 up against the 1911 small from Sailor. The 1911 is slightly longer at 13.3 centimeters versus 12.9 for the M120. Uncapped, they flip the script with the M120 coming in at 12 centimeters versus 11.6 for the 1911. I'm probably the only one who finds it interesting that they trade 4 millimeters in each direction. Moving on, the sections compare tipped flare being 1.8 centimeters on the 1911 and 1.5 centimeters on the M120. And the section diameters are a millimeter off from each other, with the 1911 at 8.5 millimeters. And we're also gonna find the 1911 being heavier at 20 grams versus 15 grams for the M120. So what does all this mean? Well, if you're good with a shorter 1911 length, you're probably gonna be good to go with the body style of the M120. I mean, as long as you can deal with losing 3 millimeters on the section. To Pelikan's credit, those threads are actually pretty comfortable. But how does this pen write? Probably the most important thing about this pen is the nib. Pelikan nibs can be a little divisive, but this one was very well done. This is a steel broad nib and was super smooth right out of the box. And while I would normally prefer stock silver steel, I'm glad Pelikan chose to go with a gold color complement. Now, this writing sample is being done in my Masubi Tomoe Folio notebook, and our ink of choice is Pelikan Edelstein Topaz. This is one of those times where I'm going to have to cave in and marry this pen to a particular ink. At least to me, this makes for a nice complementary pairing. The ink is a slightly drier ink, so the superb flow of the feed in concert with a wide nib means I'm going to get the full dynamic range out of this ink. And on top of all that, this is an amazing writing experience. Sure, the pen isn't like squeaking, but it's smooth, impressively so in fact. You know, depending on who you ask, Pelikan nibs can be a roll of the dice, but I guess I'm lucky because I've never had a bad out-of-box experience. As I'm writing, the threads don't feel intrusive, the section has a nice concave feel to it, and unposted, the pen has a nice balance and feel. Now there is a caveat here though. If you choose to post the pen and you have smaller hands, you may find that you have to fight a little bit to keep the nib in contact with the paper. I mean, this may not seem like something that would be aggravating, but having a pen that feels like it's skipping, when in actuality it just got thrown off balance, it really can get to that point. But overall, I find this to be a comfortable writing pocket pen that, I mean, as long as you can find it on sale, is well worth the price. So that's it for the iconic blue Pelikan M120. If you like the video, hit that thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, while you're down there, consider becoming a patron. Contributing just $1 a month goes further than ad revenue for providing things to review on the channel. I mean, that and dog treats. But till next time, don't drink the ink.